Chiara Carcano is restoring a treasure, a long-lost piece of our local history.
I think it's a very romantic story, the fact that paintings painted not so long ago vanished and then resurfaced.
This story began in the 1930s, at the height, or the depth, of the Great Depression. Millions of Americans were out of work.
In the 1930s in Seattle, the unemployment was 35%. In Wenatchee, it was probably closer to 60%.
President Franklin Delano Roosevelt responded to a desperate situation with the New Deal.
We cannot fail.
The government showed up, and they lent a hand. They gave them jobs. They gave them hope.
The Works Progress Administration, or WPA, was part of the New Deal. It was a government-sponsored employment relief program to put people back to work.
Did it end the Depression? No. But maybe it helped people stay alive. Literally, the WPA did help people stay alive. It gave them money to live.
Among many other projects, WPA money built the Grand Coulee Dam, funded a cannery in Kirkland, and created a Washington State guidebook. It brought art, theater, and music closer to the people by supporting artists and communities across the country. In Seattle, one of the artists hired was Jacob Elshin.
Jacob Elshin was born in St. Petersburg, Russia in 1892. He and his family fled the Bolsheviks after the revolution in 1917. They settled for a while in Shanghai, China, and then came to Seattle in the early 1920s, around 1923.
In 1937, Elshin began a WPA mural project at West Seattle High School, the first mural he ever painted. The first panel, called Landing, portrayed the arrival of the Denny Party at Alki. The second, Barter, showed the immigrants trading with Native Americans. The third panel was called Logging.
Jacob Elshin's mural for West Seattle High School has three panels, and the last panel, entitled Logging, is the second theme of most New Deal works, which is to say, depictions of the heroism of people working.
The mingling of past and present, which Elshin used in this mural, was another WPA theme.
Views of early days juxtapose against modern scenes, which is to show people that we are advancing as a civilization, and the Depression is a stumbling block, and it's a hard thing, but we will move out of it as we always had in the past.
So how did the mural end up here, damaged and needing restoration? It was one of three local WPA mural projects painted by Jacob Elshin. But while Elshin went on to become an internationally known artist, his Depression-era murals all but disappeared from public view. One hangs in Seattle's University Branch Post Office, although not in a public place. Another was rescued from the demolition of the Renton Post Office by the director of the public library there, who had it restored for display in the library's Highland Branch. And the West Seattle High School mural disappeared for many, many years.
The three pieces were installed in the school in May 1938. They hung in their original installation site above the entrance to the auditorium until 1954, when a major, major remodel took place in the school, which altered that whole area where the mural hung. At that time, they were removed because we have pictures of right before the remodel and immediately after, the murals are gone. There's an entirely new entrance to the auditorium.
So where did it go? And why didn't anyone miss it? By the 1990s, the mural didn't even show up in the Seattle School District's inventory, but at least one person remembered it.
I started getting interested in the WPA at a very early age, and I naturally, being from Seattle, wanted to find out as much as I could about the work that the artist did here. So I sent a letter to the principal at the time in 1995 asking them if they knew anything about the mural and giving them some background on the artist.
Eventually, Seattle Schools archivist Eleanor Taves began some detective work. The mural showed up in old yearbook photos, so she knew it had been hanging in the student activity room until 1974. After that, nothing.
Then we were left with no trail. The trail went cold.
And then, in 2000, the school had to be vacated for another major renovation. Eleanor went through every corner of the building, but no mural.
We were leaving the school, and we were sitting in the principal's office. I remember it so well. And just saying, It's great. It's great. All the things we found and that we're going to be able to preserve. But where's that mural? So we were just sitting there. And a teacher walks by. She's rushing out. She does a double take and she says, "Are you by any chance Eleanor Taves, the district archivist?" And I said, "I am. What can I do for you?" She says, "Well, there's a message here for you. I was supposed to tell you and I almost forgot. Mike Gervais, the art teacher, says he may have something for you." And you know, it was like I nearly fell off my chair because I knew.
And so the mural was found, wedged behind a cabinet among student artwork. The panels were somewhat battered and bruised, but they had survived.
I was amazed by the good condition they were in, considering that they were stored who knows where for so many years. The surface, aside from dirt and, you know, being dulled down by grime, was still in such a good condition.
Chiara Carcano, an art conservator, read about the discovery in the paper. She'd been interested in the WPA art project and its support for artists for a long time.
A few years ago, I actually purchased a study for a WPA mural by Jacob Elshin. So by having one, I was, of course, curious to see something else. And that's why I called the school district. I went and took a look at them.
The Seattle School District hired Chiara to clean, repair, and conserve the mural panels. She is using techniques that will protect them for the future. As she works on the mural, Chiara sometimes has to guess about missing pieces. An important part of this conservation project is documenting everything she does, with both photographs and notes.
Whenever we invent something like this curve or this little crests of the grass, we want to document it well and make it self-evident. That's not the artist. Elshin did not do that. That's my work. And the goal is to make it part of the composition, not visible from a normal viewpoint, but very visible if you are close. And so everybody will always know, okay, that's a restoration. That's a missing piece.
Sometime in 2002, the mural will be returned to a place of honor at West Seattle High School.
We are taking into consideration factors such as light, temperature, visibility from a certain angle, how many people will come to see them, how we're also taking into consideration the training of the students so that the students know and understand the history of this mural and understand the topic, the theme, and take pride in this mural, then maybe things won't happen to them again.
Jacob Elshin lived in Seattle until his death in 1976, and some of his paintings hang at the Seattle Art Museum. Soon, when West Seattle High School reopens, there'll be another place to see his work.
I think he was proud of the work that he did. I think he would have been excited to know that his mural for West Seattle hadn't been destroyed. It meant a lot to him, that first mural commission. It really meant, in the midst of the worst depression in American history, that he was going to survive as an artist. That mural was that important to him. It meant that he could carry on. And it got him a lot more work. So I think he'd be very happy that it survived.